Hello and welcome to the last TV show of this year. Today we're discussing Hollyoaks. The award-winning teen soap has been going strong for 13 years. We're meeting the commissioning editor, producer, Bryan Kirkwood, and Hollyoaks' bad boy, Niall Rafferty, played by Barry Sloane. We're looking at how the show's changed over the years and why there's now a spin-off at 11 p.m. Who's supposed to watch it? But first, Hollyoaks. Now, Channel 4 regard their long-running teen soap as a huge success. It gets very solid viewing figures of up to 2 million, and more importantly, nearly half of them are from the 16 to 34 age group that the show is really aimed at. Hard to remember now, but when it first aired on the 23rd of October 1995, it had just a main cast of 7. Well, while early episodes of Hollyoaks were more about parties, snogging, boyfriend trouble, it quickly evolved and started hitting a very broad range of serious issues. Abortion, abuse, addiction, bisexuality, bullying. If I carried on through the alphabet, we'd be here all night. It recently won a Mental Health Media Award for Emma Rigsby's portrayal of anorexic character Hannah.
Oh. Hannah,
tell us what we've done wrong. Tell us what we've done to upset you.
Mom.
It's okay. Melissa, open your eyes. It's okay. Melissa, stay with us. Melissa, look at me.
We need an ambulance.
Melissa.
I don't know.
Melissa, look at me.
Please, where's this ambulance? She's dying. She's not breathing. Please, hurry up.
And here to answer our viewers' questions and some of mine, the commissioning editor of the show, Camilla Campbell, Bryan Kirkwood, the producer, and Barry Sloane, who played character Niall Rafferty in the show. I mean, Bryan, I mean, in terms of the storylines, is that a very deliberate thing that Hollyoaks decided to do pretty early on in terms of very controversial and high-profile issues?
Well, I've been producer for the last 3 years, so I can only speak for that period of time. Ironically, I don't really like issue-led storylines. I think that they can be a little bit too heavy-handed, a little bit too angst-ridden. I just like good storylines, full stop. And if they can be about humanity and about friendship and about growing up and firsts, then that lends itself perfectly to a Hollyoaks storyline. Something like the anorexia was a good case in point.
So it's not a mission to educate?
Really not, although I'm sure some people don't believe me. It's a question of telling good storylines that engage with our audience. And if we can educate along the way, then that's a fantastic kind of side issue.
Let's have a question from Doreen. Hi, Doreen.
Hi. I've got just more of a comment about Hollyoaks. I mean, I'm a big fan, and I say that the storylines are really good. Like, teenagers can relate to them. But you just said that... it's not for educational purpose. I used to think it is. How come it's not educational if it's targeted to a teenage audience, maybe?
No, I mean, I'm really flattered that you think it is. What I meant to say was I don't set out to make it educational. I think if you set out to kind of hit the audience over the head with a pamphlet, then you're going to alienate them. I'm really delighted that people think that they can take something away from it that means something. As I said, we set out to entertain first and foremostly.
Barry, how much do you think about, you know, the viewers and who's watching when you're doing this show?
Yeah, we take it into consideration all the time. I mean, you're always wanting people to invest time in the character that you're portraying. And also you want people who are watching the show to be engaged and to enjoy the storyline you're putting across. So it's always in the back of our minds. Yeah, viewers are so important to the show. I mean, that's why the show has been such a success that it has been, because of the committed following and the people who watch the show. So,
Janie, where are you? What's your point or question?
I think the storylines are quite sort of predictable now. I think you see something that has been done all the time. And what annoys me is that you never actually try to do the storylines as what they should be doing, the right thing. It's always like morally, it's like, as if they're like stupid, the characters, like, you know, they always seem to do the wrong thing, rather than, and I think because you've got such a broad viewers from like 15 to 34, it's in one way you are responsible.
Melodramatic moment in a recent Hollyoaks, which is the everyday blowing up of a church.
I can't kill him. What? No. Does it hurt? Does it?
I'll kill you!
No! It's over! It's not.
No! Well, I mean, Barry, you play an absolutely nasty piece of work in that. And I suppose the sort of, you know, the morality question kicks in here, Bryan, surely.
Sure. Well, it's fair to say that Hollyoaks isn't everyone's cup of tea. I think that in terms of our characters doing the wrong thing, I think that's probably where most drama lies. I think that most of our characters eventually make the right choice, having made mistakes along the way. The interesting drama lies in watching them make those mistakes. And obviously, like any soap, like any film, like any piece of entertainment, we have our big, slightly exaggerated characters like Niall. But by and large, I think that most of our characters are kids, are students, are people embarking on adult life, doing things for the first time, their first job, their first relationship. And that's where our audience is engaged in, is watching them make the same mistakes that they're making at home.
Now, obviously, I mean, it, sort of the recent development, if you like, is Hollyoaks Later, which is the late-night spin-off, going out at 11 o'clock. I mean, Camilla, this is a teenage show. Why are you running a spin-off at 11 o'clock? Who's supposed to watch?
Teenagers can watch telly at 11 o'clock. It's Hollyoaks, the main show, is aimed at teenagers and young adults. The Hollyoaks Later is a treat for the older viewers. So our job at Channel 4 is to make sure that it's clear that it's distinct from the main show and that we schedule and market it accordingly. So it is post-Watershed, it has a different name, it has a different title sequence.
And it clearly does things that the earlier show wouldn't get away with. I mean, let's have a look at one clip.
Oh, and I thought you two were trying to avoid us.
All right, y'all.
I'm sorry about your dad, Mal. Really sorry, you know. I mean, he always had the time of day for me. It was a terrible state, him being buried, passed off as a landlord in Chester. I mean, how those cruel, twisted Aegis thought they could get away with it, God only knows, and then exhumed.
Explain.
I've seen worse, 11 o'clock at night. Yes, it's aimed at the older end of our market, and we have to make sure that it's clear that it's distinct from the show. And I think if you're a viewer of the main show, and you don't see that, you're not going to have any less of an enjoyment of the main show.
OK, who wants to come in here? Yes, the lady up there.
I don't really agree that there's any point for the late-night show, because I think the issues that are raised in the late-night show are raised in the earlier show, and the only difference is there's a couple of swear words, bit of sexual references, bit of nudity, and I think it's unfair on the people who don't get to catch that show, because then they miss the plot. And I think also it ignores your younger audience, because then they don't understand what's going on. If it's put at a late night show so that the kids can't watch it, isn't that ignoring that age of your audience?
Okay. Well, thank you very much indeed. We're going to have to leave it there. But thank you very much indeed for coming in. Thanks for your time. Our website's there for you to air your views on today's debates and anything else you'd like to tell Channel 4. It has some fun new extras. You can still post comments in the traditional way, but now you can also rate other people's comments with a thumbs up or a thumbs down. And you can also upload your own videos. So go to the page, channel4.com/the TV shows, and get your opinion, the TV show, sorry, and get your opinions out there.